Hey everyone, how's it going today? Just wanted to tell you that yesterday was a very busy day that was not anticipated to be as busy as it was. I had to go up to the church and meet with someone about doing VBS stuff, so that took a lot more time than I was expecting. And then Malachi fell asleep while there, so I let him nap while we were there for a little while. Got home and let the chickens and the puppy out, and then went to get some hardware parts for Malachi's toddler bed, because there was a few pieces missing whenever we put the bed together. I don't know if I just misplaced them or Malachi moved them somehow, because I did dump out the parts before I should have. So here's Malachi's toddler bed that I still need to go and get parts for. There is just a few parts. It's not like the bed's gonna fall apart not having these parts, but we do want to still get those parts just to make his bed completely secure, because with boys you never know what's going to happen with their beds, because they like to roughhouse. He likes to hop up on things and jump on things, so we want to just make sure that everything is good to go on his bed. This bed that's right here that has laundry that I need to put up today, or later today, used to be where his toddler bed is, and the bed that used to be here is the one that is now being repurposed to the shade shelter for the dog's pen and the trellising structure that we're going to add to the beans. Here is a little fort pop-up thing that Malachi got for his birthday that he is loving and likes to go in and out of, and is happy that his room is starting to come around. I was not able to get the roof on Colt's pen because I wasn't here for as much as I thought I would be. So that's a project that I'll probably do. Probably won't be today, because today is going to be another busy day. But tomorrow I can probably get to it, as long as it's not raining, because it's supposed to rain today and tomorrow. But Friday it's not supposed to rain, but Friday we're going with Simber to an event. Busy times here on the Gehöft. So for Colt's pen, I plan on getting some of this roofing, metal roofing that was here that blew off into our pool structure that was here when Simber got the place. And it's been sitting here, and we just need to find ways to use it so that's just not sitting here. We did use a little bit of it on the gate. So here's that piece that I did for that video about Colt proofing our gate, which I'll link that video up there. Now, we did add something to it yesterday. We added this piece. We ran wire through a hole that's on this piece already and put a little loop in it, so that we could put this carabiner on and attach it to the fencing like you see. And that way neighbors' dogs get loose, they don't come in very well. Now, if they're really small, they can probably still push the bottom half. So last night I did put this stone against it to hopefully keep animals out. And it seemed to work today because we had no visitors this morning. But the way I did use the tin snips to cut part of this to make it more fitting to the area we were using. So for Colt's shade shelter, I'll figure out how long and how wide I need to make the piece and get it cut out from that sheet metal that you saw or that I showed, and then just basically fit it to size. Now, I'm not going to fit it to the curve of the frame, but I'll attach it as best I can in multiple places so that it does have a secure spot. I may have to do two pieces, so a smaller piece that covers that part here there, and then maybe a piece up here, just to make it easier to attach and be more secure. And then this way, it'll, as Simber was saying in the video from the other day, it will give him shade during the early afternoon to late evening when it's the hottest here, and it'll still have enough breezeway to keep him cool, because again, we have this one end that's not covered by a board, this end to give them a little more shade, but also the frame doesn't go all the way to the ground, so there's a little breeze underneath there. There's also these little holes here that will let air come through, so you'll have enough air and not get overheated in this, because like these dog houses, they have vents towards the top, but yet it's still enclosed, doesn't breathe very well, and it gets really hot in there. It's good for keeping out of the rain, good for in the winter when it's cold, he can go in there, stay warm because of his body heat being in there, but not good for summer, especially here in Texas. It does get him out of the sun, but it's still really hot. So we're thinking that this is going to work really well and he'll utilize it. We do have a cat that likes to get into his pen that he's become very friendly with, and that cat likes to hide out, or not hide out, likes to be in the doghouse, but the other day when we put this in, he decided to lay in that corner over there where that board is to stay out of the sun. So, oh, here comes Colt's buddy, Shadow. Right, Colt. Shadow's your buddy. We gave him a sweet potato, and Colt has been loving chewing on it, and he's eating it, which is good because he gets those nutrients. So another thing that we noticed when the dogs were here was they used this deck to get to the backyard. So we rigged it so that that door is shut, and it will make it harder. So if those dogs do come back, they won't get in the back as easy, because the back is where we have some rabbits and chickens. The cats like to hang back there. This is one of those things to keep animals from getting to other animals. We have to secure areas that will keep them out. Well, if you guys aren't going to come out, I'm going to let him out. Hey, Jane. Come on. Hey, Jane, say hi. So, just wanted to let you guys know why this video is getting up so late. It's just because I wasn't able to shoot a video yesterday. And so I'm getting it uploaded today during the day, and then I'll load up a video tonight for tomorrow. And I hope you guys have a blessed day, and we'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching the video. Push the thumbs up to like the video. Also hit that subscribe button, also the bell, so that you can get notifications when our videos come out.
Check us out on our social media pages too. We have Facebook and Pinterest, and soon we'll have Instagram. The links are below. Bye, y'all.
Good job.